a US-based Biafran general, has a strong and many messages for Biafrans and the Zulu government. Don't forget, this is the same Biafran general who said last time that he's ready to arrest the fake Buhari in Aso Rock anywhere outside the shores of this very country. Sit back and listen to it. Thank you. But please, before then, do well to subscribe to our channel and Elohim will do you great. Subscribe and click the notification bell. Don't forget to give us a like and also drop your comments. Thanks to those who have done that, and great thanks to all our intended subscribers. God bless you and listen to it.
And the cabal to return to office, I mean Todd Taylor agenda. I said it before and it is coming up like a rumor. It is not a rumor. It is a plot that will later be unveiled. Another thing that will happen is that APC and PDP will collapse automatically. Another new party will come up that will be superseded by the Hausa Fulanis. Finally, an Hausa or finally a Fulani man will also become the president of the Zoo with the new party that they are going to form. All these things are just for strategies that they have put in place because they decide and they feel this is the best time for them to bring up their Islamization agenda. And we all are seeing it, but we feel it doesn't concern me. Because you are in diaspora, it doesn't concern you. Because your businesses are flourishing in Abuja, it doesn't concern you. Because you have one senator connections or the other, it doesn't concern you. Because you are in a good position on one place or the other, it doesn't give a damn. But my brother, I want to tell us that it concerns everybody. Even if you are in diaspora, it concerns you. Even if you are in Biafra land, it concerns you. Even if you are residing in the Zoo, it concerns you. But I want to tell us one thing. If all of us will come under one umbrella, there is one adage in Igbo language that said, "Na anuko ya onu ya obo ofufu, igube, bakato kwa onu ha bawa ide." Listen, let me tell us. Never you begin to see it that the Zoo called Nigeria will kill everybody at the same time. It is not possible. When the people revolt, and I want to tell you that even with their gun, they will be suppressed and defeated. They are oppressing us every now and then with gun. And all of us are taking it on smile. We don't care. We don't want to know because you have not experienced it. Because your brother or your sisters has never been affected. Because you are safe for now. My brother, you are not safe. A lot of agendas, both the border closing, all are targeting but Igbo people with their importations operations. That is why they close the border. There is no seaport operating in the east. There is no seaport for us to import our goods. All these things are just to oppress the Igbos. All these things are just to oppress the Biafran nation. All these things is just to, you know, make sure nobody rise up to support Biafra freedom. Because when they target and inflicts you with a lot of problems over your business, inflicts you with problems over whatever you are doing, you will face those ones as your ultimate problems, as your priority. And you forgot about the fact that you need to support IPOB. You forgot about the fact that you need to support Biafra struggle. That is just about what they are doing. That is why they come after our people. Just check out Allen Onyema. If I tell us what is happening in the life of Allen Onyema, most of us will not really understand. Most of us will not really understand. But it's a plot. You know why it is like that? Because he is from Biafra nation. You know why it is like that? Because he can one day decide to sponsor Biafra struggle. That is why they come after him. A lot of people has been affected. I cannot be able to mention all of them one after the other. A lot of people have been affected. And we all are seeing all these things. But the people that are yet to be affected, don't give a damn. And you felt that when the zoo happened to, you know, happened to blackmail you with one case or the other, you will spend billions of naira. You will spend millions of dollars just to free yourself from the case. That millions of naira that you will later spend to free yourself from the case that the zoo gave you would have been better and profitable if you will use it to support Biafran freedom. If you will use it to support IPOB over the struggle for the emancipation of Biafran nation, it would have been better. But you will not do that. You will just keep your hand folded until they will come after you. They are coming after people one after the other. You think Ojos Okalo will be the only one to be sentenced to jail? Listen, I told us before, and that was earlier this year. I told us, if you go through my world, you will understand. I made a video sometime, and I told us that a lot of them will be sent to jail. It doesn't mean even if you are, if you have migrated from PDP to APC or from any party APGA to anywhere at all, a lot of them will be sentenced to jail. Not even sending them to jail. Most of them are going to die in prison. You know, after a time, when I begin to say it, people say, why are you sounding that way? Why must you talk it that way? Why are you behaving like that? All those efulefus, all those people in Biafra land that felt that they cannot support IPOB, that felt they don't have anything to do with Biafra, most of them are going to rotten in jail. Most of them are going to die in prison. And that is what the simple truth about the whole matter. Ojos Okalo is now in jail. You see, when you tell Ojos Okalo, when you discuss anything about Biafra, Ojos Okalo will just tell you that Biafra is a dead story, that you don't need to talk about that. He will just try to, you know, discourage you from anything at all talking about Biafra, because he has the, you know, he has the intention of maybe becoming a president or maybe becoming one thing or the other, as he is presently a senator, but a senator now in prison. Now, since Ojos Okalo have been sentenced, 7 million or thereabout, and now has been sent to jail, what do you think about his political career? There's nothing like that anymore. There's nothing like that anymore. You see to that? There's nothing like that anymore. Socially affect, DAOG is on the line. Roger Okoracha is also on the line. Okezie Igbazo is also on the line. All these people are going to rotten in jail. You think it's a man saying? It is not a man saying. Most of them will go to jail and die in prison, because most of them are suffering from diabetes, heart failure, kidney problems. Most of them are suffering from a lot of deadly diseases, and they are going to die in prison. They are going to die in prison because they don't want Biafra to be a nation, and they cannot be outside to see the restoration of Biafra, because come 2020, brother, listen, Biafra will soon be a nation. Biafra will soon be a nation. IPOB, under the leadership of our able leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, has gone so vast in the restoration of Biafra, diplomatically. And diplomatically is much needed. Even if force will come up, the diplomatic move which IPOB has been doing is very great. It's very, very great. There is a saying that says that spirit control the physical. The spirit in this very struggle right now is the diplomatic move of IPOB. The physical is if Nigeria wants it of war, then after the spirit being the diplomatic move, we will come in the physical with war, and we will wage war against them, and we must suppress and win them. And that is but the simple truth. But one thing is left. One thing is left because you have never decided to join IPOB. One thing is left because you felt the struggle is not for you. One thing is left because you did not know your right. Because if you know your right from your wrong, you will understand that you don't need to answer a Nigerian. Sometimes they talk about hate speech. And I tell somebody that if you ever address me as a Nigerian, it is automatically a hate speech. And you have to face the consequences of hate speech for calling me a Nigerian. Because Nigeria is never a name for anybody to answer. Nobody in diaspora. Listen, you know, often at times I begin to tell our people in diaspora, I say, why is it that you don't want to join IPOB? Why is it that you don't want to join the struggle for emancipation of Biafran nation? And they will say, that is not what brought me here. I came here to make my money. That's not what brought me here. I don't come here to do IPOB stuffs. I don't come here to, you know, to contribute money for Nnamdi Kanu. Do you think you are contributing money for Nnamdi Kanu? Nnamdi Kanu is later. If Nnamdi Kanu decides to go on his way, he can take care of whatever that concerns him. But he has a vision. He has a vision to make sure that Biafra is being restored. And Biafra, as a nation, must be restored. There is no two ways about it. If you have not seen it, if you have not seen it, my brother, everybody has seen, most people, even you know, a lot of countries have seen it, that Biafra will soon be a nation. So you that is still in Biafra land, that has never seen that Biafra will be a nation, I said it's a pity. It's a pity. It's a pity. It's a very big pity that you've not seen that. What are we waiting for? Our people are against us. The people that are supposed to be with us, the people that are supposed to support us, the people that are supposed to join IPOB, the people that are supposed to fight for Biafra restoration are fighting against Biafra restoration. Most of our people, you know, they try to divide us. They try to bring divisions among us. Most of us are IPOB members. But I want to tell us that even inside IPOB, there are a lot of saboteurs. Most people in IPOB are still sabotaging the struggle of IPOB, are still sabotaging the struggle of Biafra. Then what are you thinking you are doing? You are but killing yourself. Most of our people went as far as organizing one forum or the other. Most of our people went as far as organizing one name or the other, just unlike BSMS, as they call them themselves. They only choose to fight against IPOB. They only choose to talk against IPOB. They only choose to talk against Nnamdi Kanu. They only choose to talk against IPOB. Is that how to fight for the struggle? If our EBU leader did anything in the platform of IPOB, they would talk against it. Is that how to fight for the freedom? Why can't you come up and talk against the impostor in Asurok? It seems as if people have forgotten that the person that is ruling Nigeria is not Buhari. Buhari is long dead. Hey, what is really happening to them? All these so-called senators, why are you people so blind? Why is it that the allegation, okay, let me call it an allegation, Nnamdi Kanu alleged that Buhari has died since 2017 and buried in Saudi Arabia, that the person in the seat of rulership in Asurok is not Buhari? Why is it that even the Senate, why is it that even the lawmakers, why is it that people don't talk about that? Does it mean it's not a problem that they're supposed to talk about it? Why must Nnamdi Kanu say that we're supposed to know or find out the truth about what he has said? Why is it that since Buhari has claimed that he's in Asurok, why is it that he has never come up with corporate wears that he used to put on suit before, so he can remove his cap? Why is it that he cannot remove his cap? Let us see his. Why is it he cannot do that? Why is it that people don't want to talk about that? Why is people afraid saying that Buhari is dead and Jibril is there in Asurok? Listen, if I happen to see Jibril outside the zoo, if I happen to see Jibril outside his zoo, I will let him know that I am a general. I will let Jibril know that I am a general. If I sight him anywhere in diaspora, I personally happen to sight him anywhere in diaspora, I will get him handcuffed. I will get him handcuffed. I will just handcuff him and make sure I bring him to book. If I happen to see Jibril, outside in diaspora, anywhere at all, and I happens to be there personally, I'm not talking about anybody, Personally, I happens to be there, I will get him handcuffed. I will put him handcuffed and make sure I hand him over to international authority for him to be questioned, for him to be investigated, because he is not Buhari. Jubri is supposed to be handcuffed and push away from Asoro. Let Biafra become a nation. Why are you people afraid of saying that Jubril is the man in Asoro? Why is it that nobody can talk about that? Why is it that our so-called senators, our so-called governors, why are you people ashamed? You people are a very big shame. Woe to all of you. Cowards you are. All of you are but cowards. Representing the people in the high, in the federal prosecutors without a voice. You cannot open your mouth and say that Jubril is the one sitting in Asoro. Jubril is not Buhari. Buhari is dead. If personally I happen to see Jubril outside, I said I will handcuff him. I will handcuff him and get him arrested and hand him over to the international community for them to investigate him as a general, because he is an impostor. He is an impostor. He is impersonating Buhari. Buhari is dead. I am not happy. I am not happy because the people representing the people in the federal parasitos, they don't have voice. Jubril has to be arrested. It is time to focus on this Jubril matter. We don't need to talk about anything but to get Jubril arrested. I have gotten handcuffed for Jubril. Anywhere at all I see Jubril in diaspora, I will get him arrested. Anywhere at all I see him outside the country, outside the zoo, I will get Jubril arrested. Jubril has to be arrested. This is the time to arrest Jubril. Jubril don't have to be there more than this year. Jubril has to be arrested. Has to be a problem. Has to be the trade of the season. The matter about Jubril has to be everything. Everybody must have to be concentrated talking about. It is time to do away with this stupid. It is time to do away with this rubbish. Let Jubril be arrested now. Jubril has to be arrested now. We don't have to discuss about any other thing. Because if Jubril is not there, all these tyrannies will not be happening in the great nation called Biafra. 460-something Boko Haram that was sent to cell, that was sent to jail, was released just for no reason's sake, that they have repented. And they converted them from Boko Haram into the military. For what? So that they will be killing the Biafrans. And all of them have been sent to Biafrans. Listen, sometimes I watch in the house when they are debating. When they are debating, they said from Lagos to East, you have about 700 or is it 70-something, about 70-something checkpoints. Or 270-something checkpoints from Lagos to East. And when I look at it, I said, when have we come to this extent? Having all these checkpoints is not targeting any other person. It's not targeting the Fulanis with their cattle. It's not targeting any other people but Biafran nations. They are the people they are targeting. I want to tell us something. You know, often at times people will say, why is it that the military will not go to Sambisa Forest and fight Boko Haram? Which Boko Haram do you want them to fight? The Boko Haram are training themselves. The Boko Haram are Nigerian militaries. They are training themselves in Sambisa Forest. After they finalize their training, when they graduate out of their training, when they are fit to go, they will capture them and convert them to Nigerian military. Then send them to the East for them to fight us. Why do you think we have a lot of checkpoints in Biafra? Is because they want to extort money from us? No! Listen, the zoo, the so-called Nigeria, is very, 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 very afraid of Biafra. Of Biafra to rise up again. But soon, Biafra will rise. Biafra will rise, oh. Yes, Biafra will rise. I want to tell us something. In the time of Otokoto, Otokoto and Co. did a lot of things. But one blood of Ikechukwu revoked the whole thing they did. And they were captured and apprehended. One day, the tyranny, the military, the zoo, We kill only but a blood, and that blood will cause the war to come up. One day, very soon, very, very soon, the state of the country is very, very, I don't know the best objective to use to qualify it, the state of the country. But one day, just but one day, very, very soon, only a blood, it might be a local blood of nobody, but that blood, as strong as it will be, will cause the war to burst out. Then what will be your position? You that don't want to support IPOB, you that don't want to support the Biafra restoration, you that is dying before your actual death. You know, most people, listen, let me tell us, most people, I interact with them. You know what they told me? They said, my brother, it's not that I'm against Biafra, it's not that I'm against IPOB, but you know, if you say you are a Biafra, before you know it, your life is at stake. You see? Because they choose to die as cowards. And that is why cowards died many times before their actual death. Does it mean that the zoo has killed all IPOB members? The more they kill and bury us, the more we germinate. On daily basis, people are joining IPOB. On daily basis. But because of fear, you decide that you will not join IPOB. You that is watching me and has never joined IPOB, as a good and transparent movement for this emancipation of Biafra restoration, you are a coward, and that is why you have not joined IPOB. A lot of people, even in diaspora, they say they don't want to identify with IPOB. Why? Because they are afraid. Why are you afraid? It is destined, one as a day for somebody to be born, also destined one day for the person to die. Nobody will live perpetually forever here on earth. Everybody has to die. And you don't have to be afraid of death, because one thing must kill a man. I keep saying it. I am not afraid of death. Personally, I'm not afraid of death. If I die today, somebody will still die tomorrow. You that kill me today, someone will still kill you tomorrow. Or another thing might kill you, because something must kill a man. A lot of my friends have died in the year past. Why must I be afraid? Most of them are in the so-called zoo, Nigeria, and they claim to be generals. Generals without war. None of them has been to war to become a general. They claim general to be general without wars. None of them have tested battle, but they claim general. None of them has seen fire, but they claim general. They claim general. You that feel you are a coward, you will die many times before your actual death. It is better for you to embrace IPOB as I'm talking to you today. It is better for you to do whatever you think you can do on your power to support IPOB, directly or indirectly. We don't even need you to come up directly. If actually you have money to support IPOB, brother, we need money. We really need money now. We need money. Listen. Never you begin to think you are giving money to IPOB for Nnamdi Kanu. No. If you think like that, you are stupid, because you are not seeing what we are doing. Nnamdi Kanu cannot trek from United States to Australia. He has to use flight. He has to use flight. He don't have any other work but fighting for Biafra restoration. All those people that are being killed by the zoo, even those that are being sent to cell, even those that are being shot and sent to hospital, most of them are being treated by IPOB. IPOB is a very good organized platform, in the sense that there is division of labors. Nnamdi Kanu, at times, not even at times, Nnamdi Kanu don't know how much IPOB have unless he asks about that. IPOB not only in Nnamdi Kanu. It is not only Nnamdi Kanu that is IPOB. Everything Nagana near IPOB, with a lot of people, not only in Nnamdi Kanu. Nnamdi Kanu doesn't see anything about money in IPOB, because he is not a treasurer. You know, that is what I want to tell you. Never you begin to think you are contributing money for Nnamdi Kanu. Even before now, Nnamdi Kanu has been eating and eating very well. That he decided to fight for Biafra restoration doesn't mean he don't have anything doing but to fight for Biafra restoration. But he hates oppression. That is why he decided to fight for Biafra restoration. My brother, it is hard time for you as a billionaire to support IPOB, to support Biafra restoration. Whatever it takes, whatever it takes, it's but your support. Whatever it will take us for Biafra to be a nation, it's your support. Your support morally is needed. Your support financially is needed. Why are you exempting yourself? Why do you think they will not come to for you? They have will definitely come for you. If they will come for Innocent, if they will come for Allen Nwachukwu, Onyema, sorry, if they will come for Ojo Zokalo, what do you think you are that they cannot come for you? They will definitely come for you. So it's hard time. You that is building in Biafra Nation, you that is building your skyscraper in Abuja, you that is building your skyscraper anywhere, building your hotel, anything at all you are doing, it's hard time for you to join and support IPOB. You might not be able to come up on the street to shout Nzobu Nzobu any by any and to be molested by the zoo security officers, both their military and their police. But if you are not among those that will do that, why not be among those that will sponsor IPOB financially? Why not make calls on how you can sponsor us? IPOB really need your sponsor. IPOB really need your sponsor. Eke Ronwe Eke, you have money. You don't have to run in the street. There must be a nation for you to be molested by the zoo police or military apparatus. But support IPOB with your wealth. Support IPOB with your moral contributions. Support IPOB indirectly, even if you don't want to come openly. My brother, we really need your support because Biafra must be a nation. Devil, oh my, you felt the zoo will give you ticket or chance for you to be president come 2023. You are automatically a stupid human being. You have not even learned anything from the one that has happened to your brothers. You have not learned anything. You understand? The Ohanaeze Ndigbo and Nyanwodu, you think they can allow you or maybe your descendant or anything from your clan to come up as a president come 2023? All you guys are dreaming. All you guys are dreaming. When our able leader, Nnamdi Kanu, said there will be no election in Biafra land, I made people to understand that even if he happens to call up the election, which he finally did, that there's no way you will win the impostor in Asoro. There's no way you will win the cabal. And even when they make move, our able leader, Martin Nnamdi Kanu, said it, that the election had been rigged automatically. Because finally, you will go to court. And when you go to court, who has the final say? They want the position. In fact, I don't know. But still, up to today, people are still thinking of becoming Igbo president. How stupid people are. They still don't see anything. They have not even seen the handwriting on the wall. And that is why, because of such thought, that they felt something like that will come to be, make them not to support IPOB. Make them, when you talk about IPOB, they will say, I am not in that train. I am not in support of that. I don't think anything like Biafra must be, because they have their focus one side. Most of our people that was staunch IPOB, hardcore IPOBs, when the election boycott was called up, felt maybe somebody has collected. So that is why he asked us also to go and vote. That is automatically nonsense if you think that way. Listen, let me tell us. Because of you, that is why Nnamdi Kanu call up the election. For you to still understand that even if everybody in the zoo votes in Atiku, as you thought then, that the cabal, the impostor and the cabal will never allow any other person to win the election. You know, all these things, he said it. But you still want to cast your vote. Since your vote did not count in 2019, okay, you think your vote is going to count in 2023 when you are thinking of becoming Igbo president 2023. And that is why you don't want to come up openly to support IPOB. When you are a big time billionaire, a businessman in Biafra land, and they are giving you instructions, they are giving you conditions on how to go around along with your businesses, and you felt it's okay for you to manage like that, they will finally come for you. They will finally give you allegation and send you to jail, even if you do it or you didn't do it. Yes, even if you do it or you didn't do it. If I tell you how much Nigerian government has spent to fight against IPOB, you might not believe it. They have spent millions of dollars to fight against IPOB and Biafra. And that is but the simple truth. The money they are lobbying into international communities, the money they are lobbying, giving as bribe in international communities, just to make sure they silence everything about IPOB and Biafra. My brother, it's not a chicken change. All those money that EFCC are maybe getting from one way or the other, from people they say they loot money and all the rest, has it been accounted for? You don't ask yourself a question. Why is it that we are still up to date under road construction? Any government that come up will promise you, we will construct this road to this road. We will do this to do this. We will do this to do, but all those things are but fallacy. They just make it as a promise to obtain your vote. Not even obtaining your vote, because as it stands, even if you like, you vote them. Even if you like, you don't vote them. They have already selected their people. I mean 2023. They have already selected their people. Before May next year, you will see a lot of wuru-wuru and mago-mago and the hara-hara and the kati-kati in APC. In APC before May next year, big problem is going to come up in APC before May next year. A lot of people will be affected. Those people that is shouting for APC, somebody like Rotimi Amaechi, you will see his own disgrace will be more than what you think that is supposed to be. Rotimi Amaechi will be disgraced the way that people will say, wow, is that how it happens? Yeah, Rotimi Amaechi will be disgraced the way you don't even expect it can be. A lot of them will be disgraced in APC. I mean, before May 2020, a lot of them will be disgraced if Biafra tarries to come, because Biafra must become a nation. If you travel abroad and you see what is happening, you see the speed of development in diaspora, my brother, you shed tears. You shed tears, and you cannot be happy. You cannot be bold to answer a Nigerian. Woe unto you that always. Why is it that if I see you in diaspora, if a foreigner sees you in diaspora and asks you, where do you come from? Why do you choose to say you come from South Africa? Why can't you open your mouth and say you come from Nigeria? Yeah, you don't want to support Biafra. You don't want to be a member of IPOB. You don't want to, you don't want to fight for Biafra restoration. I said, why is it that if a foreigner happened to see you abroad and ask you, which country did you come from? Why are you not so proud to say I am from Nigeria? Why do you claim you come from Cameroon? Why do you tell them you come from Ghana? Why do you tell them you come from South Africa? Why do you tell them you come from Ethiopia? Why can't you open your mouth and tell them you come from Nigeria? Since you are not ashamed of that very country called Nigeria, why do you choose to lie and tell them you come from South Africa? My brother, it's hard time. You have to swallow your pride. If you have pride to support IPOB, swallow the pride and support IPOB. For IPOB is a very big transparent movement that is fighting for the restoration of Biafra as a nation. You have billions, but to support IPOB is very hard for you. Sometime about 4 months ago, or thereabout, in Philippines, all these Yahoo pastors, you know, often at times I tell people, most of them are not pastors, they are but oppressors. I did not say there is no genuine pastor still remaining in Nigeria. I didn't say so because I know the genuine ones are still in existence. But listen, 95% of pastors in Nigeria, 95% of pastors in Nigeria are but fraudsters. 95%, you see how I put it? If not 98, in short, 98% of pastors in Nigeria are fraudsters. They are not pastors, they are oppressors. They are instructors. They just instruct from you. And they give you the hope. When you behave well on earth, when you pay your tithe on earth accurately, when you live appropriate on earth, that you have a hope of heaven to come. Why they will enjoy their own heaven here on earth. They will buy one private jet and the other. They will build private school with their own money. And that money you gave them as a tithe, which they, you know, arranged and build their private schools, your own son cannot be able. He has power. Tell me a blind man that you know very well that is blind from birth, or yes, from birth, that has been healed by all these pastors. Tell me a crippled that you know was born crippled by birth, you know too well, and has received his healing from all those pastors. Tell me. I saw in social media one woman that has a default in her hand, and that deformity in her hand, she can straight it. She can use her muscle inside her and straight it. I saw many pastors roast that woman and they do the miracle of, you know, raising up his hands again. I saw many people, I know, many pastors use that same woman. That is what they are doing. And when they did it in the congregation you are, because you are not aware, because you don't know, you felt that is miracle. That is not miracle, my brother. That is not miracle. I went to a church sometime. A pastor used an ignite light, a flame, an ignite a flame. People were surprised because he used handkerchief and water to ignite a flame. A flame come up in the handkerchief and people was amazed. That is reaction. That is chemical reaction. And if you don't know about it, you don't know about it. There is a chemical when being dropped on a cloth. If you pour water into that cloth, flame will come up. That flame will be like greenish color, like bluish color. It is not harmful. That is reaction. But people see it as miracle. People see it as miracle. Listen, we have something that there is something they call gravel incense. When a pastor will take them to the water, to the sea, or to the river at midnight, they will put gravel incense inside the water, and the gravel incense will light up in the water, and you will see flame in the water, and they will force them to believe that that is the spiritual woman or whatever, whatever that has come with fire to make you. You see why people are still blind. All those things are little magic that you can even do. Listen, I remember the time, if you bring a paper like this and use candle and write in that paper, candle is white in color. And when you write something with that candle in this paper and use black paper that you burnt, and use paper that you burnt, the charcoal, and rub in that paper, you will see written things. And people will see such things and say it is miracle because you are blind. Because you don't know anything. They use little things to convince you. They will send their colleagues at night to come and bury their charm, the charm they prepared. What they prepared as charm in their indoors, they give to their messengers to come and bury it in your compound. They will then tell you that they want to come and do delivery in your compound, and they will come and dig it out. When they dig it out, you say they have done magic, and you believe it. My brother, you are still very blind. You are still very blind. Most of all these oppressors that call themselves pastors has caused many havoc, has caused many problems in their families, has brought divisions in many families. They have brought a lot of divisions in many families. I see somebody in social media. He is wearing a charm in his leg. He's wearing a charm in his leg, and he is digging a ground, pouring water to bring out charm that is being buried, until he forced the one in his leg to fall out. But unfortunately to him, the guy he was trying to do that knows all about how it used to be, and he catched him and asked him to bring out the charm. You see what they are doing, and you believe there is miracle. Brother, miracle is far from these people. All these people that you felt they can see, they are using black magic, and miracle is far from them. What they are doing is black magic. All the native doctors has converted their shrine to churches, and you keep going there in the name of miracle. What? Listen, let me tell you the prophecy. A pastor that is up to 40 years, any woman that is up to 40 years, her most serious problem is to have a husband. Any woman that is 40 years that has never given a birth, the problem she has is to have a baby, to get married and have a baby. So when a pastor come in the church and said, yes, you have been for a long time, you keep having disappointment from one man to the other. Oh, you are here in the church, blah, 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 blah. I can see you, but today you have received your miracle. Your husband is here, blah, blah, blah. You shout, I receive. You are crazy. You are crazy. You think that is prophecy. That is not prophecy, my brother. A pastor will tell you that when you are taking shower, you will, all often at times when you want to take shower, the soap will fall away from your hands, and you believe it. That is seeing, that he is prophesizing. You are crazy. And when make a star hunter happy, can you be up to 35 years or 40 years as a woman without being desperate looking for a husband? Can you live with a man without giving birth to any child up to 2 years? Do you think the pastor will not see that your problem is to have a baby? All those things are not prophecies. All those things are not prophecies. A pastor will tell you that your sister is the problem behind your marriage, and you believe that. You believe that. All those people are but scammers. Don't believe them. They just want to extort from you. I call them oppressors. I don't call them pastors. They are oppressors because they are oppressing you with religion. They keep oppressing you with religion, and you keep believing them. And you keep believing them. You keep believing them. Somebody will waste his time from morning till night in the church. Then how do you think you can survive? Family, how do you think you can survive to take care of your responsibilities when the only responsibility you have or you think you can do is to while away your time in the church in the name of to receive miracle? What miracle do you want to receive? What miracle? Somebody will pray and say, open doors. Brother, listen, let me tell you, if you fold your hand, even the same Bible you are using tell you that if you don't walk, you don't need to eat. There's no way you can stay without work, and you think miracle will come from heaven for you to get money. How can you get money when you don't work? You have to work for money. If you want to get money, you have to work for it. Yeah, the Bible said if you don't work, you don't need to eat. So if you think you can sleep in the church from Monday to Friday, and miracle will come next week, and you will get money, it's a lie. Often at times they will coin you with their colleagues and tell you that you will receive unexpected alert from listen. Something like that doesn't happen. It doesn't exist. If anybody tells you that money, you will receive an alert in your account that no, you will not even know who sent it to you. It is not true. It's a lie. Forget about those stupid women. Forget about those stupid boys or men that will come to the church and give testimony in support of what the pastor said. They want to create awareness for you to believe the pastor. At the back, the pastor used to give them their own share. You are stupid. You are stupid, though. You are stupid believing them. You are stupid believing them in terms of miracle and all the rest. They are liars. They are not doing anything. They are just suppressing you. So, brothers, what I am trying to tell us is that it's hard time we have to come together. It's hard time we have to stop fighting ourselves. If you are a member of whatever organization or group you call yourself, my brother, we all are fighting for one cause. IPOB is fighting for Biafra restoration. Your own organization, as you said, is equally fighting for Biafra restoration. And if that happens to be the case, there is no need for you to counter whatever IPOB said. There is no need for you to talk against IPOB on their own platform, on their own way, on their own pattern of fighting for the freedom. We are fighting for one thing. Let us fight together for one thing. You know, we all are not blind. We all are aware. And we see how it goes when Masob is on the train. When Masob is ready, we all see how far they gone. We all see how far and what they did on their own strength, on their own platform, on their own strategy for restoration of Biafra. We all know and see how far they go. Now, IPOB is on the forefront. My brother, Inhabanaka, Ejiginyelea, IPOB is a very transparent organization. Our able leader, Martin and the Kano, said our food are counted. Our food are counted is whatever we are doing it with sincerity. If you are coming inside IPOB because you felt you can come inside IPOB and get money, my brother, better stay on your own and open your own where you can, you know, turn it as a source of income. IPOB, any staunch hardcore member of IPOB, my brother, we always spend our own money. We don't get money from IPOB. IPOB is not a company that pays money. IPOB can only assist you if really you are a member of IPOB and something so serious happens to you while in the struggle. IPOB must be there for you. If it when you can get money through IPOB, I mean, assuming in the course of fighting for Biafra restoration as a member of IPOB, God forbid, the military happened to shoot you, maybe in your leg, IPOB will give you money to treat you. IPOB will give you food then. IPOB will take care of you. That is only when you can expect to get something from IPOB. If, for instance, you have been taken to jail, to cell, to court, to prison yard, IBOB will stand for you. IBOB will make sure they provide food for you while in detention. IBOB must come for your rescue to bail you out from prisons. That is the only time you can get money from IPOB. But if you come for IPOB and felt they shares money in IPOB, IPOB is not the cabal, it's not the zoo, it's not political party that shares money. No, we don't share money in IPOB. Any money in IPOB is documented. Any money you see in IPOB is documented. We know how the money is going. We are using the money in IPOB for IPOB struggle, not for individual benefits. Never you think that any money you give to support IPOB Kano. No. At times, if Nnamdi Kanu did not ask about the finances or the state of finances of IPOB, he don't know how much IPOB have, because that is not his area of operations. IPOB, we have division of labors in IPOB. So what am I saying in effect? What I am saying in effect is that if you are thinking of to get money in IPOB, you are disappointed. And that is why often at times, when they come inside the IPOB and they do not see any way of getting money, you see them backslided. You see them talk against IPOB. You see them start to fight against IPOB. You see them start to say that they don't even know what IPOB is doing. So you don't know what IPOB is doing. IPOB is doing a great job. Listen, if not for IPOB, you see, Biafra Nation would have turned to Fulani territory. That is but the simple truth, though. Forget about the fact they are still killing us. They are killing us on daily basis. But still, we are surviving. Why are we surviving? Because IPOB is shouting. Because IPOB is working diplomatically. That is why the killings are not that much. If not, the killing would have been like war by now. The killing would have been like war by now. Because most of our people has dined with the devil. Somebody like devil, oh my, has dined with devil. That is why he declared any IPOB seen on site to be shooter's side. Okay, Zee Bazo has dined with the devil. That is why they fight against IPOB. But listen, let me tell us. While still, as we are watching, while they are still alive, they are going to smell their doom one after the other. I tell us sometimes that most of them will die in prison. And that is truth. Ojo Zokalo has opened the door of prison for the Eastern politicians. And you think he is the only one that is going to be there? No! Most of them are coming up. T.A.R.G. will later follow the train. Rochas Okorocha will later follow the train. Okay, see, Ibazo, all of them will follow the train. All of them are going to prison. Oh, they will go to prison now. You will see it. All of them will be sentenced to prison. Because the Islamization agenda presently is to make sure they suppress anything high-class Igbo man. Anything high-class Biafran citizen, any Biafran citizen that is a billionaire, brother, better join IPOB now. Better support IPOB now. Indirectly or directly. If not, Mbadiga for you. IPOB now. Than when they come for you tomorrow and seize up everything you have. That little thing you think you can use to support IPOB, you will then use it to pay for international lawyer. You will then use it to, you know, find your way out from the problems. Why not use it and support IPOB now? Still and still. What I'm saying is that this is the time for us to always talk about the imposter in Asura, because I am ever ready and well prepared to get Jubril arrested. Anywhere I see him in diaspora, outside the zoo, I will handcuff him. This handcuff is for Jubril. Jubril has to be arrested. Jubril has to be arrested, handcuffed, and brought a book. I have gotten my own handcuff ready for Jubril. Jubril must be arrested. Buhari is dead. Why is it that the Senate cannot talk about that? Why is it that they cannot defend it in the Senate? Why is it that the Senate cannot say, what is the problem? Why is it that people keep saying that Buhari is dead? Why can't they talk about that in the Senate? That we need to know that situation. We need to know what concerns about all this rumor that Buhari is dead. Why is it that they cannot talk about that in the Senate? All of them that claim they talk something. All of them that claim they have voice to talk for the people. Why can't they talk and debate about if the man in Asoro is really Buhari or another person? Buhari is not living anymore. And we all know it. That Buhari is long dead since 2017. Why is it that they cannot talk about Buhari? Why is it that they keep chasing shadows? They talk about something that don't have meaning. They stop importations of rice. Then when you go to Kano and Kaduna, Sokoto, Daura, foreign rice are flooded anyway, everywhere. And you feel they are doing it for what? They are doing it because they want to suppress Biafran nation. They want to kill you so that you will not have reserve rice when they will come for war. So that they will war you with even hunger. And you felt they are doing it for what? To boost the economy. How can you boost economy and stop importation of rice when you don't have enough facility to boost your agriculture? When you don't have enough amenities to boost your agriculture? When you don't have a good meal to meal your rice, and you are stopping importation of rice? Whereas if you go to Kano, Kaduna, Daura, foreign rice are flooded everywhere. You come to social media, you will see Fulanis and Hausas piloting bags of rice with their motorbike to northern entities. And you are here, and you are there thinking that they are doing it just for them to make sure that they suppress the Biafrans. They are doing it just to make sure they squeezed all the hands of the importers in Biafran nation. Yet nobody wants to take care of it. Nobody wants to think about that. Nobody wants to see it as their strategy to Islamize the nation. My brother, it's hard time. We have to come to our senses. It's hard time. You that is a BMS, you are a member of BSMS or whatever you call yourself. You don't have to fight against your people. You don't have to fight against IPOB. You don't have to talk against IPOB. My brother, talk about the impostor. If you don't know anything, you talk about. Talk about the impostor in Asurok. Talk about Gabriel in Asurok. Don't talk about IPOB. Don't fight against IPOB. Whatever organization you have instituted to fight for Biafra restoration, it's okay. Our able leader, Mazin and the Kano, say, whatever you think you can do for Biafra to come, I am in support of it. That is what he said. He said, go ahead, do it. Then why must you be against IPOB? Why must you leave the struggle to fight for Biafra restoration and went as far as whatever you see IPOB write in social media, you can promote it. You write your own to talk against it. Whatever they do, you do your own to talk against it. Is that how you are fighting for the... Brother, you are just but a saboteur. That is what you are doing now. You think you are fighting for Biafra restoration? No! You are a saboteur. Because you said what IPOB is doing is not good. Why not do your own the way you can do it to be good? About IPOB. Embrace IPOB and so forth. But I want to tell us, if all Easterners, if every Dick, Harry and Tom that is fighting for Biafra restoration has decided, has made up their mind to come up under one umbrella, under one transparent umbrella, which is IPOB. My brother, if everybody that supports Biafra restoration can focus and embrace IPOB in oneness, in unity. You know why I said IPOB? You know why I keep saying IPOB? My brother, we all have seen the strength and the greatness of IPOB. I don't want to tell you anything or whatever. It depends on how you are seeing it. We all see the greatness of Masor during their own reign. We all have seen every other group and their platform and their own reign. And we all have equally seen IPOB and how great they are. If all of us that is fighting for Biafran restoration can forget about differences and come under one umbrella of IPOB, my brother, Omonike said, forget 3 months, Biafran will be restored. Yeah! Omonike said, forget 2 months, Biafran will be restored. Because you have like this, I'm telling you the truth. You know, often at times I keep saying it on my own view. And that is what our hero, our late hero, Ojukwu said. He said, you can only remove oppressed with a counterforce, because it is only force that is being used to oppress. They use force to oppress us, and it is only a counterforce that can suppress us from that oppression. That is my own view, and I believe in that, and I keep saying it, and I will say it even to today. If war happens to come, if war happens to be, if Biafra restoration happens to be of war, personally, as a general, I will be in the forefront. Personally, I must be in the forefront. If Biafra restoration happens to be of war, I will personally command the troop. I will personally be in the war front. I will personally fight for Biafra restoration as a general. I cannot die a coward. I cannot say, no, I will not fight for war. Listen. Mbamu di kenamba kamuni bea. Mbamu di kenamba kamuni bea. You don't have to die a coward. Let's come together and join IPOB. Let's come together for this Biafra restoration. Biafra is the only hope we have. We don't have any other hope. If they are giving you hope of 2023 to become a president, to become a governor, to become a senator, all those things are but scam. My brother, all those things are but scam. Listen, mark it one place. If Biafra tarries not to come 2023, there will be no election in Biafra land. This one is not going to be after they will call up the election. No. Nobody will call up the election, because even the one our every leader did by calling up the boycott election, all of us see how disappointed we were. So nothing like calling back the election again, no matter whatever document that is being signed, no, because as long as the cabal are sealed in the seat of rulership, they will continue ruling you that don't want to join IPOB for Biafra restoration. They cannot leave the seat for any bastard. They are not going to give anybody like an Igbo man to be president come 2023. That is a dream that can never happen. That is just but a dream. Even it's not just a dream. It's a malaria dream. You are being affected by malaria. That is why you dream stupidly. If you are thinking of 2023 to become a president, to become a senator or whatever, you are stupid. Awusa, and the Fulani will still remain in the seat of power come 2023. Not even a Yoruba man. Listen. Forget about Jagada of Lagos. What is his name? Forget about that. Nothing like that will happen. Forget about Yemi Osinbajo. Forget about Yoruba to be president 2020. Nothing like that will happen. Forget about Igbo to be president 2023. Nothing like that will happen, my brother. Nothing like that is going to happen, though. Nothing like that will ever happen. There is no way a Fulani man will allow you, Igbo man, to come and rule over them. The one Obasanjo did, in fact, is a mistake. Ebele Jonathan is also a mistake, because Yaradua died in the seat. You see to that? So they cannot make such mistake again. If they did not succeed coming up on third party, third team, which I know they will still bring it up. Top ten. I said it earlier this year that they will come up with top ten. Or is it maybe last year? I said it last year that they will come up with top ten. And now it's coming up as rumors. Top ten is coming up as a rumor. Yeah. And I have said again that before 2023, APC and PDP will collapse. They will bring up another party that members of APC and member of PDP we join together to form the party, and that party will win the party that will win APC. When that party will win APC, because some people will say APC is not good, PDP is not capable, When that party will come, they will win APC. But it is still not them demo. They will win APC and bring out another Hausa Fulani to start ruling you for another 8 years so that the Islamization agenda will keep on going. Yes. The Islamization agenda will keep on going. Then you are thinking about Igbo presidency 2023. That is a typical scam. That is a scam now. It can never be. When I keep telling people that it can never be, it can never be. It cannot. It will never. It will not be. It can never be. It cannot happen. Why will it happen? Have they removed Tanko? No, they have not removed Tanko. Even if they remove Tanko, they will put another Tanko. And when you do all your mago, they will rig the election and you say you will go to court. Finally, what the court said is what you will take. Now, you see what happened with PDP and Atiku. Finally, Atiku have accepted defeat and the ruler and the rules from the court. You think they have not compensated Atiku? Do you think they will tell you they have compensated Atiku? Atiku is also a full animal. Do you think they will tell you they have compensated him? He has been not do anything. What do you think he can do? He has went to court. He cannot do anything. He will just take it and smile. Do you think Atiku will come up again to contest for election? Maybe he can come to Fulani again to follow him, so that it will be as if there is election. My brother, it's hard time we have to come to our senses. All the big time millionaires, billionaires in Biafra Nation, this is hard time for you to put call. Contact Radio Biafra. If you don't know any other one you can contact Radio Biafra and ask how you can support IPOB and Biafra Restoration. It is very much needed. We need your support. The war is with us already. We need your support. The war is with us. If you know what is good, it's better you do it when there is still time. Do it now than tomorrow, for tomorrow may be too late. They are coming after you guys one after the other. Look at Innocent. Sometimes was given a condition to move his company headquarters from to Uguawosa. You see the type of condition Nigeria always give you as a Biafran billionaire that felt you don't want to support Biafran struggle. You see the type of condition they give you. They will give you one condition or the other to do it like this or to do it like that. They will tell you to move your company from here to there. They will tell you, give you one condition or the other because you are stupid. You don't want to support Biafra. Because if Biafra happens to be a nation, my brother, about that smart, you will see people from many parts of the world looking for visa. After 10 years of Biafra being a nation, you will see people from many parts of the world looking for visa to go to Biafra nation. Because Biafra, as a nation, my brother, it is going to be very, 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 very sweet a country. It's going to be very, very organized. It is going to be very organized. And that is why I asked us to come under one umbrella. That is why I asked us to act under one command. It is good for us to act under one command. Because if we don't have one command, we can have rebels among us. Even as we are rebelling again among us at present, somebody who is a member of BSMS, I often see him writing jargons against IPOB. Anything IPOB do, he must write. My brother, why not concentrate and write about the impostor in Asuron? Jubril is the one ruling you and you are happy. You have never talked about that. You have never evangelized about that. You have never told people to get him arrested. You are ashamed. You are afraid. But you are dying in shame. Because you are a coward. That is why you fight against only IPOB. Maybe if they give you a little peanut. If they give you peanut. And you felt you can talk about IPOB. Against IPOB. My brother, go and look for work to do. Get your ring, IPOB has come to stay. IPOB has come to stay. And every Dick, Tom, and Harry has seen the level of IPOB, the greatness of IPOB. Listen, IPOB is worldly recognized. Whatever platform you have instituted in Biafra land to fight for Biafra restoration is not acknowledged in the international community. When you want to talk about Biafra in international community, they will only ask you, are you a member of IPOB? Because even everybody is aware of IPOB. And even you that is talking against IPOB, my brother, are also a member of IPOB. Yes. You are automatically an IPOB. Even if you want it or you don't want it, you are automatically a member of IPOB as long as you come from Biafra Nation. Because IPOB simply means indigenous. You are an indigenous people of Biafra. Indigenous people of Biafra. That is the full meaning of IPOB. So automatically, you are a member of IPOB. You are an IPOB. You only need to identify with us. So fighting against yourself is stupidness. You that is fighting against IPOB and you are a Biafra, you are very stupid because you are also fighting against yourself. IPOB is just but indigenous people of Biafra, which you are one among us. Why do you choose to fight against us? Why do you choose to write against whatever IPOB has written? Why do you choose to countermand their own instructions? Why do you choose to walk or talk against them? A big shame. A big shame to you that is talking against IPOB without knowing that you are talking against yourself. Because IPOB is just but indigenous people of Biafra. My brother, we need to come together. 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 There's no more time. There's no more time. I decided not to talk to us again in social media, but often at times I shed tears. Often at times I shed tears. And if not of our able leader, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, if not on how he has been trying to calm a lot of us down, because a lot of us are very radical, that we can start up something, even if we don't finish it, but we can start it. A lot of us are too radical, that we can march the zoo anytime, but our able leader, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, keep asking us to calm down. He keep asking us to calm down, because he wants to make sure he has finished up with the diplomatic moves. If we conclude with the diplomatic move and we get ready to march, my brother, come closer so that you that feel that you are strong enough, you that feel that you are a warlord, you that feel that you can go for war, so we can march together. Because personally, I am not a coward. Personally, I'm not a coward, and I can never be a coward. Personally, I'm not a coward, and I can never be a coward. If Biafra restoration happened to be of war, I must be at the war front. I must command the troop, and I must make history. If Mazin Nnamdi Kanu asks a lot of us that is radical to calm down and pipe low, maybe things would have started happening in the zoo by now. But still, IPOB is doing a great work. Underground, physically, the one you are seeing and the one you are not seeing, diplomatically, many ways, IPOB are fighting for this Biafra restoration. But we need their support. We need their moral support. We need their financial support. Support IPOB, for it is a moving train. Support IPOB, for everything we are doing in IPOB is very transparent. We don't have any hidden agenda. Support IPOB for Biafra restoration. I will soon stop this broadcast. I will soon stop this broadcast. I've talked much worse. And I believe a word is enough for the wise. A word is enough for the wise. But the most important thing we should start to talk from now henceforth is to get Jibril, the impostor, arrested. And I have made a promise. Anywhere I see Jibril, the impostor, Anywhere I see him outside Nigeria, I will get him arrested as a general. As a general, I will get Jibril arrested. I will handcuff him and hang him over to the security officers for more interrogation. I will handcuff him and hang him over for more interrogation. Jibril has to be arrested. Get your own handcuff. So we will together arrest Jibril. Enough is enough. Enough of this dictatorship. Enough of this tyranny. Enough of this killing in Biafra land. Get Jibril arrested. Let Jibril saga be the most trending saga this very season. Let us talk about Jibril. Buhari is there. If they say Buhari is not dead, let Jibril come up and remove his cap. Let us see his bare head. Since people are not seeing and people cannot understand what is happening, that Buhari is there, Jibril is the one in Asorok. Why is it that the Senate cannot talk about it? Why is it that our so-called politicians cannot talk about the Jibril the impostor? Why is it that they are afraid to talk about that? Why is it that they don't want to talk about it? Why is it that they don't want to talk about it severely to know what is really happening? Many people in the international community, even UK, send a and it is there in the paper. A lot of evidences that confirm that Buhari is dead. Yet, our senators, our governors, our so-called politicians, our so-called patriotics, our so-called whatever they claim to be in the so-called zoo and the Biafra nation has never opened their mouth to talk about Jibril. All of them will start to say, if I open my mouth and talk, what is that? What are you talking? The only thing you have, call a spread. Jibril is the one presiding the rulership of the nation called Nigeria. Jibril is the one presiding, not Buhari. Buhari is long dead since 2027. Buhari is dead. Let that be the problem. Let that be the issue that everybody should talk. Buhari is dead. Why must you allow Jibril to keep ruling us? By the assistance of the cabal, killing us, converting Boko Haram from prison to military, and sending them to Biafra nation to kill us. And all of us fold our hands. Millionaires, we fold our hands. You cannot decide to make sacrifice. Even if it is 10 million naira, and it's even a support. Billionaire you are to support this struggle. As a billionaire you are, why can't you support IPOB? Why can't you support Biafra Restoration? Secretly, if you cannot come up initially, one mayor secretly, you are accepted. We understand. Most of us are not even ready to join IPOB because we are afraid. Most of us, if you talk to them in diaspora and say join IPOB, they will say, no, that is not what brought me here. I come here for my personal issues. I didn't come here for IPOB stuffs. You see, my brother, it's hard time we support IPOB because Emekwelu may Allah. Biafra is a spirit. Biafra is an ideology. Biafra can never be erased. Even before the amalgamation in 1914, Biafra has been in existence. When you go to the ancient map, you will see Biafran bite. You see what I'm saying? So Biafra has been in existence before the amalgamation, before the British came in. Biafra has been. And Biafra is an ideology. It can never be erased from the surface of earth. Biafra must finally become a nation. Woe unto you that felt Biafra will never come. Woe unto you that don't want to support Biafra restoration. Woe unto you that we finally rotten in jail because you fell. You want to be a senator. You want to be a president. Come 2023, you will not be outside to see that 2023. A lot of them are going to rotten in jail. A lot of them are going to die. Yeah, many of them will die in prison. Yeah, many of them will die. I said it before. When I said it, somebody will say, oh, why are you talking like that? Why? But it's true now. It has started. It is true. Most of them are going to die in jail. There's no way Hausa Fulani will allow you to become anything you think to be a president, Igbo president. That is fallacy. For a Yoruba man to become president 2023, that is malaria dream. Yeah. Even if Jagaban of what they are calling it, whatever they are calling him, to be a president from Yoruba, come 2023. That is malaria dream now. Anyanwodo or anything from his clan to be a president come 2023. That is typhoid fever dream now. All those things cannot happen. All those things are must come. Nothing like that. Yeah, nothing like that will happen. But one thing I still have to tell us is that 2023 cannot work out. Yes, because Biafra, if Biafra tarries to come, if Biafra did not come before 2023, my brother, there is not going to be anything like election in Biafra land. This one is not that after indictment they call it. No, nobody will call it up again. Nobody will call it up again. We are not casting our vote as Biafra is. We are not casting our vote. Nobody is going to call it up again. We call it up. Nnamdi Kanu call it up because of you that felt your vote can count. Nnamdi Kanu call it up because of you that felt if we didn't call it up, our brother will be affected. My brother, these people has decided to Islamize Nigeria and not Biafra, because Biafra will soon be a nation. Biafra will soon be a nation. I thank you everywhere that you have watched. Please, try to tell anybody around you that person in Aso Rock is not Buhari, is Jibril. And let them know that Jibril has to be arrested. As I have personally made up my mind that anywhere I see Jibril, I will get him arrested. Brother, make up your own mind as well. Go and look for your own handcuff. If you don't have handcuff, look for a construction that will construct handcuff, local handcuff for you. Let us get Jibril arrested. Since the senators, since the House of Representatives, since they don't want to talk about that, since they don't want to talk about that because they are afraid, because they are all involved. All of them are looters, all of them are criminals, all of those people. They only concentrate on their posts now. All of them are looters and criminals. They cannot talk anything because they are involved. One way or the other, they have eat a lot of money. Unlike Ike Ekweremadu. You know, people begin to talk about Ike Ekweremadu. Brother, if they told you how much Ike Ekweremadu embezzled, that Ike Ekweremadu, as he stands, cannot talk any stupid. If not, very soon you will see Ike Ekweremadu. EFCC will come for him. Ike Ekweremadu. EFCC will soon come for Ike Ekweremadu so that you will understand that he has been eating your money. You understand? So that you will understand that he has been keeping your money. But you see that stupid guy that work against IPOB lawyer. No problem. But one thing for sure is that IPOB is ready to give you IPOB treatment. Anywhere we see you in diaspora, you will receive IPOB treatment. Because we are everywhere. Anywhere at all we see you in diaspora, you are going to receive IPOB treatment. And anywhere at all, personally, I see Jibril, I will get him arrested and hand him over to the authority for further investigation. I am stopping this video right now because I think a word is enough for a wise. If you want to know something, you know something. But one thing I want you to know for sure is that IPOB has come to stay, and Biafra is a nation that must be. There's no two ways about it. There's no way you will say you don't know that Biafra will soon be a nation. Biafra is already a nation. Biafra is already a nation. Biafra is everywhere. Everywhere in the world has known about Biafra. Biafra is everywhere. 2020 comes Biafra as a nation. He said.